Hello, I'm Helen Bradley. Welcome to this video tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can train the quick selection tool in Photoshop to do the lion's share of the work in making a selection. Before we get started on this tutorial, let's have a look and say what it is that we're trying to achieve. And this is the original image that we had here. It has a background and it's going to be really difficult to extract the image from the background because the colors are so similar. So we're going to need to make a selection to get the image from the background. Once we've made the selection, I'll show you how to make it a little bit neater using the mask that we're going to get as part of the selection process. And then we're going to add a background in just so that we can see how good our selection was. And we'll finish off with a curves adjustment just to bring some detail back into this image. But basically what we're going to do is look and see how we can harness the power of the quick selection tool here to make the selection for us. To get started on this process, we're going to go back to the original image. This is the statue image, and I'm going to target the quick selection tool. Now, this is a tool that can be trained, so when you get started on it, it may select too much or too little, but it's prepared to learn as you go. You can size the tool up a little bit bigger if you want to, and you can increase its hardness. I'm going to leave it at fully hard, but I am going to increase its size. And you can also increase its size using the square bracket keys on the keyboard. And so to make my selection, I'm going to start by selecting over the portion of the image that I want to keep, which is this statue here. Now, as I go, you'll see that it jumps a little bit and it takes in some areas that I don't want. But right now, I'm just concentrating on the areas that I do want. So I'm just going to drag around here to get most of the area that I want selected. And it's gone over a little bit. So now it's time to go and train this tool. So I'm going to press Z to zoom in. And I'm going to drag over the area that I want to zoom into. And then I'll hold the space bar down as I move the image so I can see clearly what it is that the problem is. Now I'm going to reselect the quick select tool, but you can see that it's got a plus sign in the middle of it. If I hold the Alt or Option key, this turns into a minus sign. And what happens when I paint with it now is that we're removing the content. So we're telling Photoshop that it went too far in making that selection. And I can also size down my brush. So I'm going to start working on a much smaller brush. And again, with the Alt or Option, I'm going to click in here to say, you got it wrong. But the result is that in actual fact now Photoshop has undone some of the selection I already had. So I'm going to let go of the Alt key and just drag very carefully over those areas that I do now want included. And Photoshop will learn as we go and it will make a better selection each time. So I can tidy up this area a little bit. And I'm going to tidy up in here because it removed an area that I did want to select, but now it's gone too far. So I'll hold Alt or Option so I get the minus sign and just drag over the area I want removed. And I'm going to do this all around the image. So I'm going to hold the space bar as I move the image and then go back, let go of the space bar and use the minus key and the brush without the minus key selected to just fine-tune this selection. And as we go, Photoshop's going to get a whole lot smarter at making this selection. Now, I would work all the way around this image, just trying to fine-tune this selection a little bit more before we go on to the next step. So I'm going to try and get as good a selection as I can with this tool, but without spending a lot of time doing so. So again, moving by holding the space bar, then letting go, minus key, or turning this brush into a minus by holding Alt or Option to wipe out the areas I don't want included in the selection, and then letting go the Alt key to get this plus option, because this plus has been selected here up in the tool options bar, so I'm now adding to the selection. If you're not seeing the plus symbol, if your selection is being replaced each time, then you can either click this option here or hold the shift key as you drag with this tool, and that adds a plus symbol to it, so it behaves as if it were selected up here on the tool options bar. I've just got a little bit more to fix around here, and then once I'm happy with this selection done to what I've got right now, I can just zoom out. I'm going to press Z for zoom, and then in my case I'm going to click the Alt button to zoom out. And now I'm going to choose Select and Refine Edge, because the Refine Edge tool allows me to now refine the edge on this selection. Now, while we're working on Refine Edge, we can still zoom in and out of this image, and we can also use the spacebar to move around, so you're not forced to make your image the right size before you actually get into this tool. You can use the tools here, or the features here, to get a better selection. I'm going to smooth mine just a little bit, and I'm going for a slightly more contrasty edge, so I'm going to increase the contrast. I'm already seeing a couple of areas that could be improved on, but I'm going to do that in a minute when I get back with my layer mask in place. You can experiment with other options here, but you'll see that some of them are just bringing back in detail with the underlying image. And for example, shifting edge will allow you to shift the edge out, so we're making a bigger edge, or we could shift the edges in to cut into the image a little bit more. But since I've made a reasonably good selection to start off with, I'm pretty happy with what I have here, just with a little bit of smoothing and perhaps a little bit of a feather. It's giving me a pretty good result here. So if I'm happy with what I've got here, I'm just going to output to a new layer with a layer mask that's going to make a duplicate of this layer with the layer mask in place. So I'll just click OK. And here's my duplicate layer with the layer mask in place. Now, so that I can see what's going on, I'm actually going to add a new layer to this image. So I'm just going to click to add a new layer, and I'm going to fill it with this blue color by pressing Alt Backspace on the PC, Option Delete on the Mac, and that will let me see a little bit more clearly what's going on in this image. And I'm also going to zoom into it a little bit closer. Use the space bar to move the image around. And now I can see where places on my mask might need some attention. So I'm going to target the mask layer here. I'm going to select a brush. Now I've got a 9-pixel brush, which is really quite a small brush here. And I'm going to paint in black because that will allow me to mask out these areas. I'm going to click here right on the edge of my selection and then shift click to just paint along that line. I like the click shift click option. Click shift click because it paints in a straight line and it removes some of these little bumps from my selection. Click and then shift click, and I'm just going to go around the edges and just fine-tune this mask. But you can see that the quick select tool has done most of the work in masking this image for me, and all I really need to do is to make some very minor selections with the brush here, some minor adjustments to the mask, to actually end up with a really, really nicely masked object. And done pretty quickly, pretty much I've masked this object out and selected it and managed to cut it out from its background while we've been doing this video. I haven't stopped and done anything that you haven't seen me do. So I'm just going to finish up around here. I'm actually going to brush this area a little bit here. Try not to brush, as it really needs a fairly steady hand to brush, and I do better with using the click shift click. But just checking around here to see how that selection looks, and I'm pretty happy with that. So I'm going to zoom back out so that we can see the selection, and I'm going to add a curves adjustment to this to bring out some detail in the statue. So we'll do layer, new adjustment layer, curves, And the curves adjustment is just going to lighten the lights and darken the sort of mid-tones and darks in the image. And it's bringing in some of the green from the original statue, which I kind of like as well. So that is adjusting the statue. And let's just go back to this layer. And instead of filling it with just a solid fill, one of the things I like to do is to click on the gradient tool, click on the radial gradient this time, and just drag out a radial gradient. So it looks like I've got not the gradient that I want. I do want this foreground to white gradient. And let's just try that again. I'm just going to drag until it's in the position I want. So it gives us a little bit more of an interesting background to this image. But that's how you can train the quick selection tool to help you make a better selection of an object in Photoshop. And it really is quite a handy tool to use. I'm Helen Bradley. Thank you for joining me for this video tutorial. Look out for more tutorials on this YouTube channel and consider subscribing to my channel so that you'll be alerted when new videos are released. And visit my website at projectwoman.com for more tips, tricks, and tutorials on Photoshop, Illustrator, Lightroom, and a whole lot more.